You're listening to episode 160 of The Art of Living Big. Before we get started on today's episode, do I sound really clear? Because I have a new little setup. I feel very professional, you guys. If you're new here, forgive me for just a second, but if you've been here, I have a new little setup so that the sound is better. So I have high hopes. I did this because I am creating a really cool, I think really cool, hypnosis library for you guys. So I went to the beach this past week. I was there for like almost a week. It was so much fun. And the beach, we went to Daytona Beach in Florida, and it's just beautiful there. The ocean is the best, and I love the beach there. The sand is really good. And I spent the whole day or the whole week in a cabana at the Hard Rock, and it was so awesome. Every morning, I got up and watched the sunrise. And one of the last mornings we were there, I got up, watched the sunrise, and I walked out to the ocean as the sun was coming up, and I recorded some of the ocean sounds. It came out so good, you guys. I'm so excited about it. But what I've been putting together is a hypnosis library with lots of guided self-hypnosis audios for you. But I wanted to get some ocean sounds so that we could create some subliminal messaging for you guys. So inside the library, there's going to be some subliminal messaging with the ocean sounds, so you can play it while you sleep. You can just play it in the background while you work during the day or whatever. You won't hear the commands that I'm giving unless you listen really, really good, but they are health and wealth related. So if you're interested in that, you can go to my website. Just go to betsypake.com, and down towards the bottom, there'll be a big yellow thing that says notify me when the library is ready, which should be sometime this week. You will get an email and it will explain to you how to get it. So be sure to jump on that, because I think it's going to be really great. One quick reminder that we have a Facebook group. It is, if you go to www.theartoflivingbig.com, it'll pump you right into the Facebook group. But here's the deal. If you're not a Facebooker, but you still want to know what some of the coaching is, you can go to my YouTube channel. So you can go to my website, and there'll be a link there for my YouTube channel in the top right hand. And most of the coaching videos I upload to YouTube. Not all of them, and you won't get the community, but you'll still be able to see some of the stuff. So if you're interested in that, just jump over to my YouTube channel. And now let's just get to the show. Welcome to The Art of Living Big. I'm your host, Betsy Pake. I'm an international expert in manifesting from your subconscious. And this podcast is designed to help you think differently about what could be possible for your life. Now, let's go live big. Hello, everybody. Welcome to today's show. So, all right. So I was telling you in the intro about how we went to Florida this past week, which if you're new here, the beach is sort of my jam. I have a mild obsession, and I probably talk about it a little bit too much, but I went down for a week, and I don't know if you've been following along, but I have been making it to the beach once a month. So my whole thing for this new year was no waiting, right? So I wasn't going to wait for the right time or for it to work out for everybody. I was going to just start doing stuff that I wanted to do. And last month I went by myself and spent 4 days. I did an episode on that called Lessons I Learned from the Beach, and you can check that out. It's like maybe 5 weeks ago. And then this past week, my husband and I both went, and we just spent like a week, not quite a week, almost a week, and just sat in the sun and listened to music because we had no other option, because we were staying at the Hard Rock, which is a really fun hotel, but it got a little overwhelming because there's sound all the time. They're all about the music there, which I should have known that. But in all of that, because of that, I didn't have an opportunity to really read. We got a cabana, which was like a total, I guess I'd say like a total treat, like to get a cabana every day while we were there. And it's just something that makes me feel abundant, and I like to do, and I like to have like my inside like cabana area. And the way the Hard Rock is set up, then there's outside, so I could be laying in the sun, and then when I want to get out of the sun, their cabanas actually is like a little living room, and it's got a ceiling fan, and you have your own waitress, and so it's just kind of nice. So we did that, but because we were at the Hard Rock with all of the music, it got a little overwhelming for me. Because I really couldn't meditate. Like, no kidding, at 6 o'clock in the morning on the patio, on our balcony, I could hear the music still. And when we were in the cabana, there was a speaker. Well, there were speakers everywhere, so you couldn't even pick a cabana without a speaker. But it was like unbelievably loud, where Craig and I at one point were like, I can't even talk to you. It would be really cool if you were there to like party, you know? So, which most people are. So I'm not knocking it. I'm just saying that for me, I couldn't even read. I couldn't listen to an audiobook because honestly, it was really hard to hear it over the music, even if I had headphones on. But here's what happened. Here's the good that came out of that. Because of that, because I couldn't be distracted with other things, I started just sort of listening to my mind, and I started listening to what I was thinking. And I had this moment when we were there, and you may have heard me talk about this on the show before, about how I don't like to drink alcohol because I believe that it pulls me away from my intuition. And so I have sort of, I'm going to say a rule, but it's not a rule. It's a loose rule. It's a guideline. I have a guideline that I will drink when I'm on vacation, right? So like if I want a pina colada or whatever, even with that said, I'm not a big, huge drinker. But if I want to have one when I'm on vacation, I'm not typically working with clients or any of that stuff when I'm gone, right? So the weird thing was, I had a couple drinks. I think I had a coconut mojito, and it was really good. And then I had a Corona. And as I was laying in the chair with my Corona, and it was hot. I mean, it was 95 degrees or something, so super hot. So like cold, the cold slushy, whatever it was I was drinking was really good. But I started thinking like, this is what was happening in my brain. I can't drink. It pulls me away from my intuition. Why am I doing this? Even though I'm on vacation, wouldn't I want to take really good care of myself while I'm on vacation? So now pause for just a second. Remember, I had nothing else to do but listen to my own thoughts and like, you know, baby got back for the 29th time. So all of a sudden I realized, you know, I decided that I didn't want to drink because I didn't like the marketing messages around alcohol and women. So I didn't like it that everything tells us that to be a good mom, you got to have wine at wine 0:30 clock or whatever they say. Like I got to the point where I was like really irritated by that. And I got irritated by the fact that like every marketing message being pumped to me, every cute tank top sold on Instagram was like coffee and margaritas or whatever. And it's funny at first, and then it gets to sort of not be funny to me, where I was starting to feel like, why are you marketing? Why are you pushing that so hard on me? Now, I've never been a super drinker anyway. I've never had an alcohol problem. So I didn't want to stop because I had an alcohol problem. And honestly, nobody in my family has had an alcohol problem. Like, it's not like that's been something that I've surrounded myself where I wanted to make a decision to live my life different. I truly decided because I didn't like the marketing message. Okay. So I don't like anybody trying to manipulate me and tell me what to do. But as I laid there, and I was like, I can't have this. It makes me pull away from my intuition. I was like, Betsy, is that even true? Because this whole thing of not having alcohol only started like in the last year. And there's nothing wrong with it. It's probably healthy for me to not. Like, I mean, I'm not saying it's right or wrong. I'm just was wondering about the reasoning and why we do anything, right? So your thing might not be alcohol. Maybe it's something else. I don't know. But as I was laying there, I was like, is that even true? Like, I used to meditate for hours at a time, like 2-3 hours at a time. And then I'd go downstairs and get a glass of wine. So it's not even true. But I had really begun to believe that. And if I had something to drink, then I was like, I can't meditate. I'd get irritated, or, you know, I would definitely not have any alcohol like the night before if I was going to be having a client the next day. What, I have clients every day except for Sundays. So like, it didn't make sense. I all of a sudden I was like, why? Why am I saying that? And I realized that every single thing that we decide or every single thing that we do has a meaning, right? So is the meaning that I can't connect? Is the meaning that alcohol is not good for me? Is the meaning the marketing message? Is the meaning the calories are too much? Like, it, what is the meaning? But the reality is the meaning is whatever I give it. So, okay, so let me stop for just a second and let me just say it again in a different way. Everything that happens to my life only has the meaning that I give the meaning to. So whether it's laying out in the sun and having a beer and the meaning is that now I won't be able to connect to source energy and meditate, or the meaning is I have a beer and I really relax, which allows my subconscious or allows my consciousness to fade into the background and I can connect more easily. Couldn't that be true also? Like, absolutely. If I look at it like that, absolutely. Like, I'm not as guarded. I'm not thinking as straight, right? So like, couldn't my subconscious bubble up and connect to source energy in an easier way? Here's the reason why I'm saying all this is that and it made me look at all the other things in my life that I have assigned meaning to. And many of those things I believe are true. Like, I was believing that was true. And like, if you asked me, like, why don't you drink? I would have said, oh man, I can't connect. Like, I would have gone on and on and on about it. And it's not true. Like, it's actually not true. I used to meditate all the time. I have proof of my own life it's not true. So it made me look at all the other areas of my life and do what are my goals, right? What are my big dreams? And so I want you to think right now about what are your big dreams? If you could do anything right now, if I could wave a magic wand, what would you do? Who would you be? How would you act? What would you become? Like, how would you move through the world? What is the big thing that you're trying to call into your life right now and trying to manifest? Okay, do you got that? Now, what are all the stories that surround that? And do those stories support you? And maybe the stories that you have that surround it feel very real to you. That alcohol story is a silly little story, but it felt very real to me until I actually thought about it. It felt very real. And probably the longer I thought it, the more real it would have felt. Probably to the point where a couple years from now, if I had alcohol, it might have even caused my body to react, right? Because I value being able to connect in meditation and connect to my intuition. So anything that I perceived as throwing that off, my whole body might react. And there it is. Proven, right? That my brain and my emotions and all of that, it's all connected with my body, right? My emotion about the alcohol is simply a chemical reaction. So it's my brain telling my body to create a specific kind of chemical reaction. That's what all my emotions are. So when you look at your goals and you look at what you really want, I want you to take some time this week and write those out. Right? But don't write them out to like create your dream on paper. I don't want you to do it for that. I just want you to write like easy, like at the top of a page of paper, like I want to have $1 million business, or I want to create a fantastic life with a partner that's perfect for me. Right? And maybe you're single, right? So that's your thing. Like whatever your thing is, write it. And then I want you to write down all of the reasons, all of the stories you have around that. Now, here's the thing. You're not going to know their stories because stories seems like a story, like fake, right? So you're going to think it's real. So maybe your thing around like not manifesting a partner is like, I have to lose weight first, or I'm not outgoing enough, or I'm not connected enough, I don't get out, I work from home, like whatever those things are. And then I want you to look at them all and ask yourself, is it true? Is that even true? Or can I tell a better story? Can I change the way I see this? Maybe because I work from home and I don't have access to tons of people, instead of that actually limiting me, maybe that narrows my focus because the only places I see people are the places where my people are, because it's the places I'm going that I want to go, not places I just go by default because I have to for work. Do you see what I'm saying? So like, how can that shift? How can that change? Maybe you want to build a $1 million business, but your stories around it are, well, I haven't been doing this long enough. I need more certifications. I haven't got my audience yet. Like, is any of that true? And what if you just told yourself a different story? What if you wrote your list of all your stories and you created a secondary list of all the stories that would support that goal? What if you don't even believe them, but you just remind yourself of them and you ask yourself, what if that's possible? Remember, my subconscious is seeing like 40 billion times what my conscious mind is seeing. So as you look around you right now, you're only seeing a teeny tiny little pin dot of what's available. But if you tell yourself a story, your subconscious is just a computer. It does not have any emotion about what you want or don't want. It's not like, oh, well, Betsy, we don't want Betsy to have that yet. No, all it does is it runs like a computer program. It's like an app on your phone. What is it you want? This is the story. Okay, run that program. But when I say, well, how could that be? How could that change? How could that shift? What if this, blah, 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 is my story? What would be different? What would I see? When you start asking questions like that, that is when everything shifts. That's when everything changes, because your brain has something totally new to look at. So you can keep believing the stories that you tell yourself, and even the things that as you think and you make your list, you're going to say, yeah, but that's true. But I'm here to tell you, it's probably not true. Even if you feel like everything about this is true, like you feel it in every part of your body, you're like, this is true, but this is true, Betsy. But it is true. It's probably not. Not even joking. There is so much that you don't see, that you don't realize, that you can shift. And you probably think it's true because you grew up thinking it was true, because you got that it was true from somebody else. So what if right now you can stop all that and you can start to live your own life? You can start to make your own decisions and have your own belief systems that actually support the dreams and goals you have. What if that's really our work here, right? Is to come and have the hope and dream, and then the adventure is to figure it out, to unravel what's been put upon you, and to create better systems, better habits, better awareness, so that you actually start to live towards and move towards the dream, right? Isn't that what it's here? You know, I say this to my clients all the time, is that we're adventurers, right? We're adventurers. Hello, fellow adventurer. And this is all like a big game. So if you're feeling stuck, and if you're feeling like you can't reach the goal, and if you're feeling like everything seems so hard, you got to just play a different game. And you can do it by asking different questions. And remember, everything does have a meaning. Me drinking the alcohol does have a meaning, but the meaning is whatever I give it, nothing else. It's not what my dad gives it. It's not what my mom would have given it. It's not what Craig, my husband, would give it. Craig would say, drink, drink all day, right? But the meaning is what I give it. And if I can have better meanings that support my dreams and goals, I'm going to get there faster and I'm going to have a little bit more fun on this big adventure. And that, I think, is how you live a big life. So thanks you guys so much for listening. Don't forget, I have a free training on my website if you want to learn more and you want to learn more about harnessing your subconscious to actually transform anything that you're going through, any place that you're stuck or any place that you feel like you're in a crisis into your biggest transformation. I have 5 steps and you can go to my website. Just go to betsypake.com and you will see it right there, right in front. And it'll say my free training and just click on the button and you can watch that for free. So thank you guys so much for listening, and I will see you next week. Thanks so much for listening to this episode. If you found it of value, please share it with your friends, tag me on Instagram, or leave a review on iTunes or any of your listening apps. If you leave a review and you take a screenshot, please email it to us at support@betsypake.com and we will send you a self-hypnosis audio that will help you break down any limiting beliefs that you have. So thanks so much for sharing. Thanks so much for leaving your review. And don't forget to join us inside our Facebook group by going to theartoflivingbig.com, and I'll see you there.